Are you struggling to lose weight because you're always hungry? This could be due to leptin resistance, where your brain doesn't get the right signals telling it that you're full and you need to stop eating. Leptin is a hormone that's produced by fat cells in the body that tells the brain when we're full. Leptin resistance, on the other hand, occurs when the body stops responding to the signals of leptin, leading to increased appetite and burning less energy during the day. As a result, our bodies may store more fat and we may struggle to lose weight even though we're eating less and exercising more. This resistance can also contribute to chronic inflammation, insulin resistance, and metabolic syndrome. So what causes leptin resistance in the first place? Well, there are many factors that can play a role. Number one, obesity. The more fat cells we have, the more leptin we produce. This can lead to a desensitization of the brain to the signals of leptin, leading to leptin resistance. This can lead to a continuous cycle of overeating and weight gain, making it more difficult to break free from the vicious cycle of obesity. Number two, chronic inflammation. Chronic inflammation can interfere with the signaling of leptin in our bodies and contribute to leptin resistance. It makes it harder for our bodies to recognize the signals. This in turn feeds into the vicious cycle of overeating, weight gain, and further inflammation. Now it's important to address chronic inflammation through a balanced diet, regular physical activity, and stress management techniques which can help to reduce the effects of leptin resistance. Number three, insulin resistance. Now when our cells become resistant to the effects of insulin, it can also affect the signaling of leptin. Number four, high sugar and processed food intake. Diets high in sugar and processed foods can increase the risk of leptin resistance. Number five, a lack of physical activity. Exercise has been shown to increase sensitivity to leptin. So a sedentary lifestyle can increase the risk of leptin resistance. But the good news is there are things that we can do to improve or combat leptin resistance. Making lifestyle changes such as exercising regularly, eating a balanced diet rich in fiber and protein, getting enough sleep, and reducing stress can all help improve leptin sensitivity. In addition, certain supplements such as omega-3 fatty acids and berberin have been shown to improve leptin sensitivity. So why isn't leptin being used as a treatment for obesity? Now, although leptin has been hailed as the obesity hormone due to its role in regulating appetite, it's not actually used as a treatment for obesity. Here's why. One major issue is that many individuals with obesity are actually resistant to the effects of leptin, meaning that they have high levels of this hormone, but it's not producing the expected appetite-suppressing effects. In addition, leptin therapy has shown limited effectiveness in clinical trials, with concerns about potential side effects and safety. While leptin therapy is not currently a treatment option for obesity, it still remains an area of active research and could hold promise for the future. In the meantime, the focus remains on lifestyle modifications, such as diet and exercise, as well as medications and, in some cases, bariatric surgery. Understanding and addressing leptin resistance is crucial for our overall health and well-being. By taking steps to improve our sensitivity to leptin, we can support our body's natural ability to regulate appetite, metabolism, and energy balance. It's so important to stay informed about how our bodies work and how we can support them in functioning at their best. Let's prioritize our health and well-being inside and out. I hope this video has been helpful and I'd love to hear your thoughts and experiences on this topic. Feel free to share your own journey, your own experiences, or any tips that you may have found helpful along your way. Let's keep the conversation going and support each other on our paths to optimal health.